I'm here to correct the wrong teachings of some Islamic scholars, which is the main reason, the main thing that fuels insurgency. Religious crisis exists in the world today because of false teachings from most Islamic scholars. If you're a Muslim, you need to stop the killings. You need to listen to the right teachings. Stop listening to wrong teachings from some of your teachers. Boko Haram, insurgency, call it anything you like, all these things are being caused by wrong teachings from Islamic scholars. Have you asked yourself one thing? If you stand before a Christian and say anything against God, let's assume you stand before like 100 Christians and say something against their God. I can beat my chest and tell you that 100 of them will not touch you. Not even a single soul from them will touch you. They can merely advise you and walk away, but they can never dream of violently attacking you for any reason at all. Not minding that even in the Old Testament, it was recorded that the punishment for blasphemy is death. However, because of the coming of Christ Jesus, the Christians have changed their mentality about everything. So there is no violent way again. There is no room for resorting to violence for Christians. So the problem of insurgency is, or rather, it rests on the Muslims. The Muslims are being taught the wrong thing on daily basis, at the families, at the classrooms, at the mosque. So the teachers of Islam should stop teaching Islam falsely. These are the things that fuels insurgency and Boko Haram in the world and in Nigeria in particular. So I'm here to correct some of the wrong teachings of some of the false teachers of Islam. The Quran only said in Surah chapter 4 verse 140 that a Muslim should leave the gathering of blasphemers. The Quran, there is nowhere in the Quran that it is written that a Muslim should kill a blasphemer. So it is wrong for so many Islamic countries to be codifying in their laws that once you are caught blaspheming, you will be killed. It is a wrong teaching from the pit of hell. The true thing the Quran is teaching is that a true Muslim should leave the gathering of blasphemers and not to try attacking a blasphemer. Surah chapter 4 verse 140. That is the true teaching. Then on the concept of war, everything Allah is telling a Muslim about war is with condition. For instance, Surah chapter 2 verse 193, there Allah said, fight them till sedition comes to end and the law of God prevails. If they desist, then cease to be hostile, except against those who oppress. Some Islamic scholars will come to this verse now. Fight them till sedition comes to end and the law of God prevails. They will forget about the second stanza. They will use this first stanza and be confusing Muslims. They will be teaching you wrongly and you will be fighting, thinking you are fighting for Allah. I'm here to correct the anomaly, to make sure you stop the killings. Stop listening to your false teachers if you're a Muslim. Look at the right thing Allah is teaching about war. Fight them till sedition. Surah chapter 2 verse 193. Fight them till sedition comes to end and the law of God prevails. If it is with a condition, if they desist, then cease to be hostile, except against those who oppress. Which means, if people are not oppressing you, do not oppress them. He said, if they desist, cease to be hostile, except against those who oppress, except those who oppress you. So Allah is telling Muslims to only oppress those who oppress them. So whoever that is not oppressing you, whoever that is not dealing with you violently in any way at all, you have to maintain peace with that person or persons. Surah chapter 2 verse 194. Fighting during the holy month, if the severity of the holy month is violated, is just retribution. Fighting during the holy month, if the severity of the holy month is violated, which means if it is not violated, fighting during the holy month is not allowed. All Muslims throughout the world, listen and hear the correct teachings. Stop listening to your false teachers. During the holy month, you are not commanded to fight unless the severity of the holy month is violated. That is why Allah is telling you in Surah chapter 2, verse 194, that fighting during the holy month, if the severity of the holy month is violated, is just retribution. Which means if the severity of the holy month is not violated by anybody, by the Christians or by other religions, you are not advised to fight. So Allah is only telling Muslims to fight when the severity in the holy month, when the severity of the holy month is violated. That is when you can successfully fight for the cause of Allah. If the severity of the holy month is violated, that is when you can fight. The second stanza of that verse, Surah chapter 2, verse 194. So if you are oppressed, oppress those who oppress you to the same degree. If you are oppressed, almost all the war terms in the Quran are with condition. If you are oppressed, oppress those who oppress you to the same degree. Which means if you are not oppressed, do not oppress. That is the direction of Allah to Muslims. So Muslims, stop listening to your false teachers. Hear the correct teachings from the Quran now. If you are oppressed, Surah chapter 2 verse 194. If you are oppressed, oppress those who oppress you to the same degree. Which means if someone slaps you, according to Allah by the Quran, you are advised to only slap the person and not to kill the person. Which shows that Allah doesn't want you to go out in making trouble. He only wants you to oppress. It's like the God of Christians in the Old Testament, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. That is the God of Muslims. If someone oppresses you, oppress that person. But if someone is keeping peace with you, you have to maintain peace with that person. That is the real teaching of Allah to Muslims. Muslims, please stop the killings. Stop listening to your false teachers. Most of the teachers of Islam are false. They are breeding war everywhere throughout the world and in this country, Nigeria. Stop listening to them. Hear the correct teaching from your Allah now. What the Quran says believers should do to unbelievers. What is Allah telling you as a Muslim? For you, how do Allah want you to treat a non-believer? Someone that does not want to accept the teachings of Allah. Surah chapter 2, verse 256. There Allah is saying, there is no compulsion in matters of faith. There is no compulsion in matters of faith. Here, Allah is telling all Muslims that in matters of faith, it is not by force. Don't force anybody. There is no compulsion in matters of faith. Surah chapter 2, verse 256. Surah chapter 50, verse 45. We are cognizant of what they say, but it is not for you to compel them. We are aware of what they do. That is referring to the non-believers, to Islam. We are aware of what they say. Surah chapter 50 verse 45. But it is not for you to compel them. So keep on reminding them through the Quran, whoever fears my warning. Allah is only telling you as an Islam to keep on reminding non-Islams through the Quran for his warnings and not for you to compel them. It is not for you to compel them. Surah chapter 50 verse 45. Obey God, Surah chapter 64 verse 12. Obey God and obey his apostles. If you turn away, the duty of the apostle is to convey the message clearly, simpliciter. Surah chapter 64 verse 12. Obey God and obey his apostles. If you turn away, the duty of the apostle is to convey the message clearly, simpliciter. Your duty as an apostle is to convey the message. Your duty as a Muslim, as an Islamic scholar, is to just convey the message of Allah, simpliciter, and not for you to compel them, as enshrined in Surah chapter 50 verse 45 and Surah chapter 2 verse 256. There is no compulsion in matters of faith. Remember what I said earlier about blasphemy. It is not for you to fight for Allah as a Muslim. Allah only said that if you are in anywhere where they are blaspheming God, that your duty is to walk away in Surah chapter 4 verse 140 and not to fight anybody in Surah chapter 50 verse 45. So whenever the main thing that breeds religious crisis is disbelief in killing people in the name of blasphemy, that they are blasphemers. If Muslims can stop this, there will be peace in Nigeria. There will be peace in the world. If you are a Muslim, hear the truth from Allah. Stop listening to your false teachers. 80% of the teachers of Islam are false. They are fueling crisis all over the nation. Fueling crisis. That is why there is increase in Boko Haram activities. That is why there is increase in banditry everywhere throughout the world. If you're a Muslim, hear the truth now from Allah. Do not listen to your false teachers. Take your Quran and compare whatever I've told you here with your Quran. Surah chapter 4 verse 140. When you are in the gathering of people who are blaspheming Allah, your duty as a Muslim is to leave their gathering and come back when they are done with their speeches. So stop fueling crisis in the world, you false teachers of Islam.